Hi, Stuart here with another adventure in 12 Factor. Today, number 11, Laws. As always, here's the 12 Factor definition and an excerpt from their page. I encourage you to read the whole article. It's very informative, and as always, we have some additions and thoughts to that. So no logging is bad, although if you have a good introspection tool, that's almost as good. But marrying good logging with a good introspection tool provides far more insights than either of them alone. So a good logging architecture that works pretty much everywhere, private, public cloud, hybrid cloud, is to emit logs to the one thing we know that every operating system supports, which is standard out and standard error. And the rubric is, good news goes to standard out, bad news goes to standard error. Your host should provide a way of passing those on to your cloud. Typically, they flow into some sort of aggregator. And that aggregator also collects events and state from the host. And if you're using introspection, you might have it also collect introspection data to an aggregator, which flows into an analyzer. And then you can use that in dashboards and event handlers, e.g., operator notifications and things like that, and we'll talk about that more towards the end. But I want to emphasize that the one advantage that almost every programming language has is that standard out and standard error are very low friction, and they are by their nature streams. Here are the six standard log levels, and these derive from IDLE and other places. They may have different aliases, or you know what we're calling the log levels here. This is how I usually talk about log levels. Two things are important to jump out right away. First is, don't use the wrong log level for the wrong kind of message. And the second is, pay attention to where they go. So the top two things go to standard error and everything else goes to standard out. Also, it's noted that as a best practice, if you're trying to manage the deluge that a large system might produce of log streams, that you may want to, by default, configure only the most critical and useful things to be on by default. But if you're clever, your logging framework will allow you to turn on selectively log levels at runtime, hopefully without restarting any of your processes. And I'll point out that the differences between these levels are very crisp. Fatal means no matter how many times you restart this process, it will never run. So it should never be used for transitory outages of, for example, backing services. Those would be errors. And if it's fixed, maybe a warning. What would cause something to emit a fatal error? Well, missing critical configuration would be a fatal error. Missing critical dependencies would be a fatal error. Missing critical runtimes would be a fatal error. In other words, until we redeploy the software a newer, better form, the existing deployment will never work versus errors, these things that happen at runtime. Try to go talk to my file system or SQL server and it didn't work. So I'm going to log the error just so we know it happens. And if I'm clever, I have some resiliency and retry policies in place. And if those fail, then my process will take a little nap and then it'll try again at some point. And of course, warnings are things that we put into the code to say, okay, this happened and we handled it, but it's weird, and you should probably look at these from time to time. Info are log messages specifically for business users, and of course, debug and trace are for us developers at two different levels of granularity. Again, don't mix these up. So there are some guidance things that are targeted at developers, QA, DevOps, that sort of thing. And that is, you know, prefer to use a central library, prefer to aggregate your logs in one place. Don't conflate standard error and standard out. Don't buffer your log streams, because if your process crashes, you're going to lose the logging messages that might tell you things. Avoid writing logs to the file system. Avoid writing logs to things like SQL or NoSQL. And consider investing in some sort of nice log aggregator presentation tool and maybe something that helps you sift through the logs and figure things out. There are lots of good stack for those, PaperTrace, the Elk stack, etc. They're all great tools depending on the cloud you're running in and what your business needs are and what your budget will allow. These are good things to think about. Some big time logging nevers. Don't log things that are going to make your InfoSec group go spare. Credit card numbers, financial credentials, trade secrets, passwords, cryptological keys. You probably have an information classification policy in your shop and you should pay attention to it and know it backwards and forwards. And so you know what not to log. Now, that doesn't mean that you can't log a surrogate for those. So instead of user Joe password secret 5, you could say user 421 did logged in perfectly fine. There's nothing in the log that would compromise if it was exposed. We just, you know, unless you have access to the underlying data provider, we don't know who 421 is. And it probably wouldn't be a horrible thing to say Joe. You could certainly log the last four digits of a payment card number. Although if you're really clever, your application system should never see payment information. And instead, you should use an external provider who's really good at that sort of thing. And what you get back from them is a ticket number that says, this transaction has this ticket and you can file that away. And if you ever need to know about it, you can query their API and go find out. Don't log useless stuff. It's a corollary to don't test the stupid stuff. If you have a log message, the criteria you should apply when you're looking at it is, does it not contain secret stuff? If I were trying to figure out what my application was doing or conversely what went wrong, it would be useful and it's properly categorized so that my automated tools that I bought can easily slice, dice, and julienne, and I can get different views and I can see meaningful statistics about my log streams, like how many errors per day I'm getting of what category and so on, right? So some formatting isn't the worst thing in the world. Adding correlation adds extra value, and there are lots of great correlation schemes that are available depending on your logging library. And if your logging infrastructure is part of a greater management and monitoring and awareness structure, then called MLA, what you'll be able to do is you'll be able to trace things from where they came in the front door and where they went into the depths of your infrastructure, what path they took, what they were up to, what everything else was up to, how saturated was the network, how busy were the CPUs across all these different pieces of infrastructure. And that correlation is super useful for tracking down those weird things, like detecting that you may need to scale out or that you have a problem or whatever. So correlation, if you can manage that, is really great. Here's the sort of unified monitoring picture up at the next sort of level of granularity from the first one. And that is from the entire application environment, right? We're going to want to get log streams. We want to aggregate them. And then from those, we want to decide if any of them are events worthy of the attention of the monitoring system. Likewise, we're going to get events and states from the environment. And again, we're going to decide if any of those things are worthy of bringing to a human's attention. And of course, that is what we call an incident in the operator world. So if the system auto repairs, it's interesting and we probably should record that, but we probably don't have to pass it off to our ticketing system and start waking up people via our notification system. Thank you for your kind attention.